challenges did you have commanding Camp Phoenix?
A lot of challenges. When we went over there, we were the police were dying. The Afghan police were dying at a very high rate, several hundred per month, and we were taking on a new mission. The rotation before us had just a mission of training and mentoring. When we talk about mentoring, that's the old advising mission with that with in Vietnam, where you go out in combat with the Afghans. The unit that we took over from just had the army, and we were picking up the police and actually going down and training with them and fighting with them down in the districts, down at the mud huts where they operated from. And when I remember my boss calling me in and said, I got some bad news and some more bad news. And he said that, you know, we've got this situation where the police were not trained, they weren't able to fight, and they we were in the danger of losing the programs because so many people were dying. And people would not want to join the police because of that. And that, but the 3,000 troops that were supposed to come to help us do this that you were going to get, they're going to Iraq because of the surge, but we still have people dying. And so the bad news is we've got people dying, we got, we're not going to get any more help. So I asked my people to really thin down the ranks and to go out and do some very difficult missions and put them in harm's way. Now, we took all the precautions to make sure that they could be as secure as it could be. And we never sent them without a backup. But we asked them to do some very difficult things. So it was back to that part of you care for your people, but you have this very important mission to do. And so sending people into very difficult situations where they might lose their lives in order to accomplish a mission. It's easy for me to say I'm going to put myself in danger, but putting others in danger is probably the more difficult thing that I've had to do. And we were successful. We were able to reduce the police being killed to less than 100. We were able to increase their effectiveness. And that at that point, the Afghans were fighting their own war. And so it was worth it. And then on the back end, the challenges is to help families and talk to families for those soldiers, airmen, sailors, Marines, and I had them all, even Coast Guard, those who paid the ultimate sacrifice to come back and talk to their families. And that was an incredible experience in itself, because the families would talk about their service member and how that's, I didn't have one family member go, you killed my son or daughter. And in this case, it was all males. Nobody's ever said that. They always said they were doing what they needed to do, what they wanted to do, and they were making a difference. And that's an incredible part there. And also dealing with service members and the families whose lives have been changed forever. So a lot of hard pieces in there, and it continues today because we still deal with that. But the change and the service that everyone makes it all worth it.